Hi everyone, it's Bunny. I'm a life coach for gifted and creative people. If you haven't subscribed already, please do. Give you updates on videos related to archetypes, typology, personal development, and mental health resources. So this video is actually going to be about a mental health resource or information on what therapy or behavioral health resources are. This one was inspired by a friend who actually asked me what a marriage and family therapist does. Okay, I'm not a therapist, but my education and some of my background was in pre-licensed therapy, and my degree, my master's is in clinical psychology with an emphasis on marriage and family therapy. And he, my friend, he didn't know that he could get certain therapy from a marriage and family therapist because the title is misleading. He thinks that, or thought that, MFTs only work with marriage and families. And that is something I think that maybe people don't know. Marriage and family therapists work with individuals in therapy or counseling. They can get certificates or additional education in working with addiction. They can work with couples. They do work with family systems because that's one of the major theories that we learn, to learn about how we're interrelated and affected by the family systems that we grow up in. And I think that's an important way to help someone heal, to kind of understand that the system does shape you, and then you're a result of this, you know, of all this mess that shapes you, and then there's power to adapt and overcome. So that's one of the things. Like, if you want to seek therapy, there are some options. You can go to an LPCC, that's a licensed professional, professional clinical counselor. There's art therapists, there's hypnotherapists. They don't do psychotherapy, but they help, you know, use hypnosis, maybe helping you unblock things to get more motivation, momentum towards change, maybe help you with your sleep, or you know, being more your optimal version of yourself in some way. You can always look these things up, and then I'll link some resources or words for you to look up in the future. Again, so there's a marriage and family therapist, there's a LPCC, there's a hypnotherapist, there's a psychologist. Psychologist has a graduate, has a doctorate, a PsyD or a PhD. They're both doctorate degrees, but one is more leaned towards like the clinical research, and one is more towards, you know, maybe towards working with application. You can always look those two up again to see the differences in educational requirements for what someone has in their background. Another would be psychiatrist. A psychiatrist is a medical doctor who prescribes medication. Some of them can offer talk therapy. I've only met a couple that do that, and so that's something to look for as well, because you have to advocate for yourself when you're looking for someone who works solely through the medical model. There's also, there's life coaches, there's spiritual coaches, there's spiritual healers, there are faith-based counselors. These are all different degrees and backgrounds or certificate programs that you have to look into and go through. They're all different. They're not the same. I think I mentioned licensed clinical social worker, but I'll say it again, because the program teaches more about social policies and systems in society that shape us. Like, that's why you have a social worker, right? That's why you have people who work in the county. Most likely they understand more what social policies and things in place to help protect people, or have obstacles to help people that have limited people for growth. And I think that's something that weaves in social justice as well. And I know a lot of programs are doing it more often, and yet if you work with someone who graduated many moons ago, they might have not taken a course or have had the difficult discussion about social justice or privilege in the therapeutic space, because there totally is privilege and power when you're working with someone as your healer. That's something to acknowledge, and I hope that when you decide to go find your therapist or whatever healer that you're looking for, that they right away explain the process to you. That part of it will involve a honoring of, you know, acknowledging privilege and power that you have a right to advocate for your needs and ask questions as a client. You're open to ask the healer what they're doing, you know, what the intention is with this phrase, but to also give yourself space to just trust the process. Because if you're skeptical, you know, their job is to help educate you and help you feel as comfortable as possible, because this is your time, it's your healing, and it's very important. And yet sometimes a lot of people who are professionals forget to educate their client, and they sometimes assume that, you know, this person's been here before, they've done this, like, it's not new. But there's a lot of people who are trying things for the first time. Like I said before, maybe they don't even know what MFT stands for. Maybe they think their marriage and family therapist does not work with individuals in trauma. Like, we don't know, because again, this information is not readily accessible or, like, you know, listed all over the place, where sometimes it is, but it's hard to find information. I get that too. And so those are some of the breakdowns on some of the titles and the labels that professionals can have. I'm sure there are many more as we, you know, get into 2020 and beyond. There are a lot of healers and professionals out there. I also would like to just throw in that if you're looking for someone to work with your trauma, please look for someone who works with the body, like somatic therapy, EMDR, some type of ancestral healing where they incorporate the body, because trauma is not just in your head. It's not just for combat vets. We're being traumatized right now, and I think everyone might need a little extra care. And that, again, is kind of working with the entire body. And so, again, if you're looking for a therapist to work with you to process and cope through some trauma, please, you know, advocate for yourself by finding someone who has been trained, familiar and compassionate with some of these modalities. And if not, you know, you have a right to ask for a referral. You have a right to ask for second opinions, third opinions, and resources, you know, that's part of their job, to help you advocate for yourself. So that's just a quick blurb on some of the potential healers that are available for you to look into and choose from. And like I said in my other videos before, if you're in the United States or Canada, 211 is a great resource for behavioral health things. You can look up 211.org or dial 211 to get someone local to help you look for what you need. I hope this helps, and I hope you're taking care of yourselves. Take care.